course, talked about the future of Linkin Park a few different times on this show. We continuously learn new information about what could be in the cards for the band. There's a few questions that we have, and we're getting closer to sort of finding out the answer. One question would be, is Linkin Park going to add a new vocalist? How do you replace Chester Bennington? Is that even possible? Is Linkin Park going to continue to perform? Are they only going to release original music? Or are they going to choose to do nothing at all? The band has been understandably taking their time through this exceedingly difficult process of figuring things out and realizing, you know, talking about how they're going to make things work. And in a new interview with Beats One, Mike Shinoda really cleared the air about what the future of Linkin Park might be holding, and even talked about how the band, you know, they're not able to play songs like One Step Closer, where the vocals from Chester are just so high ranging and you've got the dueling trading off vocals. That's an iconic song from the band. But here's Mike Shinoda talking, I would say, more in depth than we've heard him about the future of Linkin Park.
I mean, we talk, you know, I get texts and calls from the guys, like, and emails and stuff from everybody every couple days or so.
Do you think you'll carry on? I mean, have you had that a discussion as honest as that?
We have a lot of questions to answer in terms of how to do that. Like, it'd be one thing, like, if we said, hey, do you want to go into the studio and just write some new stuff? That's like the easiest thing in the world. Yeah, we can do that. But then what happens after that? You know, like, that's the part where it's like a big question mark. Like, I don't want to get out on stage and if it's just the five of us, how are we going to play One Step Closer? You know what I mean? If it's just the five of us, like, there's certain songs that I feel like I want the fans are going to want to hear and I want to play, and I don't know how to do that, right? So, and of course, some people will say, well, just bring some other person. And it's like, yeah, that's a nice idea, but there's a lot to that. You know, it's more than just the voice, which, number one, nobody has a voice like Chester's, so that's a huge hurdle. And maybe it's not a person, maybe it's a combination of things. I don't know what it is. And this is all just me talking. If you talk to Brad, if you talk to Dave, Rob, Joe, like, you probably get other ideas and other, because it's the other part of it, by the way, is just you have to, like, go on tour with the person. Like, what if they're just a shitty person? My gut tells me that by doing this solo record, by being out there, out on festivals, out on shows,
you'll unravel it.
You know, in the world, it affords me a greater chance that I will figure those things out naturally.
Now, there's a couple things that Mike Shinoda said here that I want to hit on really quick. One of the things that Mike Shinoda said, of course, is that they can't perform One Step Closer without Chester Bennington. So that essentially means that the band is either not going to be performing One Step Closer anymore, or they are going to find someone that can perform that, which, as Mike Shinoda said, that is a very difficult thing to undertake. And these shows that he's going to be performing on the road will give him an opportunity to kind of figure things out in terms of a live setting. The other thing that he said was, it's difficult to replace Chester Bennington. And how do you do that? There's nobody I can imagine that could take Chester Bennington's place. And this is where I turn to you guys. Is there anybody you guys can think? Let's use our collective resources here that you might think would be a good fit for the band. Of course, then that cues my memory, and Mike Shinoda also brings out, is the person a good person? That's almost more important than everything, because they have to live with these people on the road, and talent is one thing, but personality is another. And he just raised so many good points here. He's such an intelligent dude, and I just wish him and the rest of Linkin Park all the best on their continued journey to figure things out in the future. That's all for today, folks. Drop a thumbs up on this video. Help us out here and hit that subscribe button with notifications on. Ring that bell. It's the only way you're going to find out when we release new news stories. Usually every day we do that. So thanks so much. I hope to see you guys very soon for Rock Feed. I'm your host, Brian Storm.